is we discussed about different topic of habitat. Okay. Already we discussed about habitat. What is habitat actually? Habitat means area where living organisms live. Okay, next. Area or place. Which provides all needs of living organism. Third place is called habitat. Third place is called habitat. Understanding? Habitat means area or place where living organism lives. It's called habitat. Next types of ecosystem, food web, ecological niche. Like this, we discussed different types of topic. Next, another important related topic is ecological pyramid. Ecological pyramid. What are ecological pyramid? Already we discussed different types of food level or trophic level. What are they? What are the different types of food levels or trophic levels? First one, produce one, primary consumer. Next, secondary consumer. Next, tertiary consumer. These are different types of trophic level or food level. Producer, primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer. Producers means, for example, plant. Primary consumer, for example, For example, primary consumers. Yeah. Next, secondary consumer. Oh. Okay. Oh. Next, tertiary consumer. Observe. This is another trophic level. This is next. This is. These all are food levels or trophic levels. Observe. Between all these trophic levels, Yelton, scientist Yelton, proposed a pyramid-shaped structure. Ecological pyramid means graphical representation of food, listen carefully, food relationship of different trophic levels of an ecosystem by taking the shape of pyramid, Means, for example, this is the shape of pyramid. By taking this shape of pyramid, when we explain the relationship between these trophic levels, this type of pyramid is called ecological pyramid. Understanding? For example, in this pyramid, on the bottom, means all bars are present here. Each bar represents a trophic level. This bar present of the pyramid, this bar represents producer. Next, second one. This is for primary consumer. Next one for secondary consumer. Next one for tertiary consumer. Observe carefully. Here, in this pyramid, for example, pyramid of number. When we explain the number relationship between the trophic levels by using pyramid, shape of pyramid, here, producer number is more because bar of the producer is very large one. Then come back to the primary consumer. Number of primary consumer. Number is more than compared to secondary consumers, because primary consumers bought is larger than secondary consumption. When we compare these two, this is the large one. This is a large bar when compared to. Are understanding? Observe carefully. This is a ecological matrix. Construct based on this ecological matrix. First construct. Secondary consumer, they are less than primary consumer. That is why we are drawing small bar when compared to primary consumer. When compared to primary consumer. Next, tertiary consumer. They are smaller than remaining world. Observe, based on this box, we can find where low number and where more number of organisms are present. Observe here, we can draw like this. Means upright ecological pyramid. Upright ecological pyramid is it. Observe carefully. Like this, we have to construct different types of ecological pyramid. Ecological pyramid. What is ecological pyramid? What is the ball representation? Graphical representation of relation different trophic levels. Graphical representation of relation of different trophic levels of an ecosystem. By taking the shape of pyramids. It's called ecological pyramids. It's called ecological pyramids. This is about ecological pyramids. Abjohn. Next, another chapter, living and non-living things. Living things and non-living things. When we observe different types of habitat, when you observe in your surroundings, there are different types of things. There are different types of things. Some are living things, some are non-living things. In this chapter, we will discuss about characteristics features of living things and non-living things. Characteristic features of living things and non-living. Observe. Characteristic features of living things and non-living things. What are the characteristic features? When you observe in your surroundings, number of things are there. Different types of things. Plants, dogs, cats, rocks, small stones, roads, building, current pole, current wire, shops, okay, in your school, doors, fans, desk, books, okay. Next, different animals, different types of animals. Like this, we can find a number of things. In all these things, some are living things, some are non-living. How can we separate the living things from non-living things? How can we, there are different types of characteristic features. Based on those characteristic features, we can separate the living things from non-living things. What are the characteristic features? Say one. What are the characteristic features? Say one. What are the characteristic features? For example, cats, table. Here are the separate the living thing from non-living thing. Here, cat. It is a living thing. Table, non-living thing. Book, non-living thing. Dog. living. Human living. Observe carefully. These are living things. These are non-living. What are the characteristic features of living things? What are the characteristic features of living things? There are different types of characteristic features. Before discussing about the characteristic features topic, we have to study another. Of the activity one. Aim of this activity is to separate and to identify the living things and non-living things. Okay, so identify and separate living things from non-living. Observe carefully. In this activity, you have to search for different things in your surroundings. You have to search for different things in your surroundings. And you have to write the all names of different types of things in your notebook. Then how to separate the living things and non-living things separately. How to separate? Okay. For example, in the list, dog, how child, pen, paper, shop, bus, like these, they are different types. This is of one of the dog, compare. Okay, let's see comparison. character. Okay. Observe characters. First one, growth. Growth in living organism, it is present in non-living organism, it is options. Movement. Here present, here options. Digestion, you have present here. Next, excretion, you have present here. Respiration. Here present, here absent. Observe carefully. Next, respond or respond to different stimuli. Next, respond to different stimuli like light, heat. Next, different stimuli. Okay, light, heat, cold, light. This type of response are present here. Reproduction is present here. Here. Okay, observe here different characteristic features. Once observe. How to compare by taking different types of things. Different types of things. For example, by taking the dog, cat, goat, sheep. Next term, and other different ones, cow, like this, bull, different. Next, non-living thing, टेबल टेन बुक डेस्क लाइक दिस डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बट एक डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ थिंग वी कैन ऑब्जर्व एंड आइडेंटिफाई characters are present or not. Growth is present in the all organisms. Next, growth is absent here. Movement here present here absent. Of the all important ones, sir. Next, movement in living organ. Movements in living organism. Plants cannot move. You know, plants cannot move from one place to other place, but the leaves and branches, they move according to the wind flow. You know very well that. Next, remaining all animals, listen, they can move from one region to another region. Okay, movement is very important. What is the use of movement? To search for food material. Next, to create shelter. Next, listen carefully. To search for mate or mating partner. Listen carefully. These are the uses of movement. How can animals movement? Some animals have feathers. Some animals have other different types of things. Here feathers mean wings. There are different types of uses of movement. To search for food material, to search for mating partners, to search for the any other sources, living organisms should flow. Living organisms should flow on the one. Okay. Here, feathers, legs, hands. These are very important movement structures. When we observe different types of organisms, number of listen, different types of locomotory organs are present here. Some lower animals have flagella. Some here flagella means it is locomotory organ. Okay, flagella means this type of substance. These are present in bacteria, right? Bacteria. Next, other structures, pseudopodia. Pseudopodia are present in bacteria. They help for bacteria to move from one place to another place. Locomotory organs is that. Next, other one. Other different, there are different types of bacteria. These organisms that have locomotory capacity, they can show movement. Whereas plants also move. Plants also move. Listen. Plants also show movement. You know, movement of roots towards the soil. Movement of stem. There are different types. For example, runner. Understanding. Here's the roots. Soil stem. These are towards the soil. Stems means here, like runners, they can move. Next, branches. Like this, plants also fall. Next to opening and closing of stomata. Like this, there are different types of sub-characters. There are different types of sub-characters. Okay, observe. Next to non-living things. Can non-living things they cannot move, but living organisms can move and they can grow. Non-living organisms cannot move because they do not have, they cannot move. They do not have locomotory organs. They do not have locomotory organ. That is why
living organism can grow very fast.
Okay. Okay, observe one, sir.